Detective Dotto here. I'm glad you're spending time with me today. And today's video is awesome. My 7 secrets to supercharging your productivity. These are things that I do every single day that make me more productive and help me get more done. So let's dive right into it. My first secret to supercharging your productivity is get rid of all your extra screens. Go down to a single screen. I know you're thinking, what the hell are you talking about, Dotto? I love having multiple screens. It makes me feel so in power. And isn't more screen real estate good? Because I can have my spreadsheet open. I can have my web browser open. I can have my email open. I can have my word processor open. No. There's a couple of reasons that you might want to have lots of screen real estate if you're a video editor or if you're an air traffic controller. But if you're working on knowledge work, if you're primarily writing and dealing with documents and things like that, all these extra screens just create distraction. They do. And distraction is a huge issue, an increasing issue in our lives, one that I've identified as a real challenge for me to overcome. So by getting rid of all my extra screens and going down to a single screen, I find that I concentrate on what I'm working on in front of me far more effectively, which means I end up getting more done in the day. But there's the challenge. The challenge is I have to have multiple applications open, multiple browsers open. I don't live in a uni application world, do I? I use a Mac operating system, and it allows me to have multiple desktops, as does Windows now. They all allow multiple desktops and a variety of ways of managing them. So on my Mac, I have it set up so that I have my browsers open in different windows for different tasks. I have my other applications on different desktops, things like, in this case, Photoshop Elements, and I've got Keynote open as well at the same time. If I just double tap on my mouse or on my swipe up on my trackpad, I'm brought into the manager that allows me to see and be able to orient myself in all of the different desktops I have and then rearrange things if I want them to be in a slightly different order. So navigating between them becomes second nature. You're just swiping with your fingers on your mouse or on your trackpad and moving back and forth between them. So I find that I move back and forth just as effortlessly as if I had multiple screens. Plus, everything's now right in front of me. With my current eyesight, it's better because I can see everything here and I'm not leaning in and leaning out and onto different monitors to see exactly what's going on. And there's one other advantage too, is that is when you're dealing with one screen kind of, or one desktop for one application, you can go into the full screen mode and you can work on the applications in full screen mode, which again, completely eliminates all of the distraction around you. So in this particular case here, I've got Hootsuite up. It's filling the entire screen. I have much more, even though I have less gross real estate to deal with, I have much more practical real estate to deal with as I work on my one single project, which is here in this case in Hootsuite. So single screen it, it's a great idea. The next tool that I want to talk to you about is Text Expander. We have another video on Text Expander. It's a tool that I love. Now on the Mac, it costs, I think, $40 to buy it. It's free on Windows, which is a heck of a bargain. Text Expander is a keyboard macro tool that allows us to record regular keyboard strokes that we use over and over again, paragraphs, any snippets of text, and allows us to assign little short codes to them so that we can quickly enter them. If you do things like technical support or anything like that, it's great because you can have standard paragraphs ready to go. If you do a lot of web URLs that you forget and you have to remember what they are, it's great. So for example, if I'm writing a support letter to somebody about our website and I can never remember the exact syntax, the exact words for our login page, I just type in the pound key and then login, and it autofills the URL for the login. So that serves two purposes. One, it reduces the number of keystrokes that you take, so that saves you some time. But the other thing it removes the fact that you have to go up and search for the web URL in your browser yourself to figure out what the URL is to copy it into the email that you're working on. So it really works from two perspectives. It does another thing, which is one of my biggest, favoritest things on the planet, is it corrects a lot of my typos and spelling mistakes. So watch what happens. I always transpose the into T-E-H, just the way I type. So watch, I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna type in T-E, and then I'm gonna, in 3-2-1, hit H. When I hit H, watch what happens to the word. 3-2-1-H. It recognizes that it's a transposition and it converts it back for me. That saves me an inordinate amount of time every day editing my own documents. And it also saves me some embarrassment, especially for things like spelling mistakes. I think Text Expander is the best $40 you can spend on a Mac, and it's the best free tool you can get on Windows. Absolutely love it. The third super secret I have for productivity, I'm going to stay right here, is dictation. Oh, I have become such a fan of dictation. Wasn't always the case. Back in the day when we used to have dedicated applications like Dragon Dictates and stuff, although they've improved a lot today, back in the day, they weren't so good. And I tried to use them, and I tried, and I was never any good at them. They just didn't work well for me. Now, it's built in at the operating system level. Watch what happens. I hit the function key twice because I've enabled it. You have to go into, I'll show you how to enable it quickly. You go into your system preferences if you're on a Mac, and in Windows it'll be slightly different, but they also have dictation capabilities. But we go into your user panel, and there you click on dictation and speech, and then you have to turn on dictation here. And it only works when you're connected to the internet. But what happens is when you put your cursor in anywhere you normally type, you hit the function key twice, a little beep will happen, and you'll see a little microphone, and it's recording what you're doing, and I'm going to convert it into text. So let's send a quick message. Hi, John, comma, new paragraph. I'm really happy that we're going to be able to work together on this project, period. I'm very excited about it, exclamation mark. I hope you are too, period. Now, the thing is, you have to remember to always put in your punctuation. Oh, there it is. For some reason, I put my cursor down at the very bottom of the screen here, but you see it right here. I'm really happy we're going to be able to work together on this project. I'm very excited about it. I hope you are too. It works perfectly. Now, you have to be careful of a couple of things. The first thing you have to be careful of is you have to really proofread it carefully before you send it, because occasionally it's going to put a different word in, and because you've just said it and you look at it, you sometimes see what you expect. So you have to be careful and do a little bit more careful proofreading before you send anything. That's number one. Number two is you have to be careful when you send voicemail messages to people. When I get on, as soon as I start talking into a mic now, I start adding punctuation. So hi, I'm not here right now. Please leave a message and I'll get back to you, is the message that I get. And then I say, hi, it's Steve here, comma. I was wondering if you would be looking forward to going out with me tonight, exclamation mark. And I've actually done that. So you have to be careful of that as well. So that is dictation. Let me go over to my slideshow to remind me what am I up to? Fourth. My fourth tool, Hootsuite. Hootsuite is a social media dashboard. And how does it supercharge my productivity? In two ways for me. The first is I have a fair bit of social media communication that I have to do, but it's not ad hoc. It's kind of all pre-planned. It's communicating with viewers and listeners and people who follow us for a variety of different reasons. So first thing in the morning, I'm going to be tweeting out who's on our radio show today, or what video I'm producing and putting out, or commenting on things kind of that are relating to the Dotto Tech brand. So I pre-populate all of those tweets. So rather than having to do it all through the day, I use Hootsuite's publish service. So I create all of my different posts here, and they don't just appear in Hootsuite. This is another place that saves us a lot of time, not just in Twitter, but I can also post into LinkedIn, into Google+, into Facebook, into any of the other different social networks that I want to. I can post to them all through the one interface. But I can also use this tool called Auto Schedule, which will then pre-populate this into a schedule through the day. So let's take a look. We're kind of approaching midday, so most of my tweeting is done for the day. But here's ones that I wrote this morning that will now be tweeted out a little bit later today. And you can adjust the time on all of these. But this feature does two things for me. First of all, it saves me a lot of time because I'm able to compose all of my tweets and all of my communications and social media networks first thing in the morning when I like to do it, and have it all done for the day. So it saves me time there, but it also helps me to be a more effective communicator in social media space. So there is one area that Hootsuite saves me a tremendous amount of time. In research, it'll also save you time because you don't have to go into multiple networks to find mentions or to do any research. It will basically compile all of the different mentions or all of the different information you're looking at in different streams here within Hootsuite. It's worth trying out. It's free for a limited number of networks. If you have a lot of networks that you need to communicate with in your business, then you'll pay a licensing fee, but it's free to try out, and I definitely think it's one of the real great secret tools in my productivity toolkit. Hootsuite. Up next, LastPass, my password manager. Now, this saves me time, and it also makes me safer. It protects me from people hacking and from losing and accessing my accounts. So LastPass is a free, mostly free, password manager that is uber encrypted. It allows you to create super complicated passwords to really protect your identity and really protect you online. Then it installs in your web browser, and you have to have a really good password to access it, but it stores all of the regular logon information for the sites that you visit, and even ones that you only visit occasionally. That's where it really starts to show its strength. So this is actually a site that I do log into a lot. It's my Podbean site, which is where I host my podcast. But all I want to do, I can either click here in the fields themselves, or you click on LastPass in the taskbar here, or you see we have a dropdown here that allows me to autofill the forms that are here. So I just use that autofill, and it automatically fills in both the username and the password. Because you often forget what's your username at sites you don't visit regularly. So a lot of us store our passwords in text files or in Evernote or sometimes just in an open document on our desktop. We store our username, sometimes our usernames and password, which is incredibly insecure, or we use the same one for everything. Here, this allows you to have unique usernames, unique passwords, far more secure, and if you want to do, and it'll auto-populate them so you can easily log in and you just save it. Every time you enter a new site, every time you have a start set up a new account, LastPass will ask you, do you want me to save the password and username? And you say yes, and it'll even ask you, do you want me to create a better password for you? That's really hard to crack, and you can say yes to that as well. Password you would never remember, LastPass will remember for you. It saves you time, and it could also save your bacon. It saves you time because you don't go looking for passwords. You don't have to go password retrieval as we often have to do for sites that we don't visit on a regular basis. And that time adds up over time really nicely. We're into the stretch run. Evernote Web Clipper, one of my other favorite tools. Oh, do I love my Evernote Web Clipper ever so much. It installs in your menu bar of your browser, and it allows you to clip anything out of the pages that you're working on your browser. You can clip the text, you can clip graphics, you can clip bookmarks, you can take screenshots of it, and then store that information in Evernote. You can tag it so that you can find it again in Evernote. I use the Evernote Web Clipper every single day for doing research and for saving little bits of digital data that I don't want to be storing in my brain or trying to remember in bookmark files. It is, it's just an indispensable productivity tool. Definitely one of my top seven time-saving tips. And the last one I'm going to show you is kind of cute. It's called Clippin, and there's a variety of different utilities that you can install that are multi-clip clipboards. What this means is, you know, when you're working on a document and maybe you're copying a little piece of text here and then you go and you paste it and maybe you need to copy another piece of text and then go back and then the same first piece of text again. And so you're always moving back and forth, copying and pasting. Clippin allows you to store all of your different clips and it remembers them. All you have to do to clip a new piece of text is go back into Clippin and say, you know what? 3 copies ago is when I had this in my clipboard. That's what I want to paste right now. And you can choose that and just choose to paste that. You can also save it as favorites. So a little bit of crossover here with what we have in Text Expander, but it's for more temporary stuff. If you kind of stuff that you don't need to keep long term. The way I look at it is everything in Text Expander is long term things that I'm going to want to keep for a very long time. I use Clippin here for really short term clipping and pasting documents as I put them together. And again, when I need it, it does end up saving me a tremendous amount of time. So that's my seven supercharge productivity tips. Use one screen. Use Text Expander. Dictation really saves you time and energy. Pulling all of your different social media assets together in Hootsuite, massive time saver. LastPass not only can save you time, it can also save you a tremendous amount of grief. Evernote Web Clipper, just love it. And finally, multi-clipboard, which really saves you time on those small little projects when you're clipping multiple pieces of text. I hope you found this little video useful. If you have, please give us a like. And hey, don't forget, I've got a productivity workshop coming up, a course actually, an 8-part course that goes way deeper than anything we talked about here. We get right into the nitty-gritty of your productivity tools. So take a look at that. The link is just above me right now. Thanks so much for your time. I'm Steve Dotto.